Welcome to a short video tutorial of the Eigenvalue Stability Applet. You can get to the applet by browsing to math.mit.edu/daimp/eigenvaluestability.html. In Eigenvalue Stability, there are two complex planes of interest. There is the G plane, shown here in the upper right, and the lambda delta t plane, shown on the left. The function that relates these two plots is the amplification factor. You can see here when you browse to the page already the eigenvalue stability region for the forward Euler method. If you want to know the formula for the amplification factor, you can click this radio button down here, and you find that G is equal to 1 plus Z. Z here is lambda delta t, and this is exactly what our analysis showed before. Now, if you want to plot the eigenvalue stability region, remember we parameterized g on the unit circle. So g equaled e to the I theta. Here is the theta scroll bar. So if we now scroll for theta from 0 to 2 pi, you can see the yellow dot traces out the unit circle in the g plane, and then also traces out the stability boundary in the lambda delta t plane on the left here. Now, once you've decided that you want to use the forward Euler method to solve a particular problem, you first need to find the eigenvalue of the problem. Let's suppose, for example, that the eigenvalue is a real number sitting on the negative axis. So each eigenvalue will have a magnitude and a phase. You can set the phase of the eigenvalue over here, that's phi. So for our negative real number, phi will be equal to pi. So you can see now the green ray corresponding to e to the I phi. And now just click anywhere down here in the bottom right, and an orange dot appears. This plot here in the bottom right shows the magnitude of the eigenvalue against the time step delta t. So now we can set over here the magnitude of the eigenvalue. Let's suppose the magnitude is equal to, say, 100. Now we can see for different values of delta t where the corresponding eigenvalue will be for the difference equation using the forward Euler method. So as I drag delta t around here, the orange dot moves in all three plots. So you can see here if I go for a delta t that's very small, I will have eigenvalue stability because the difference equation will have an eigenvalue here at this orange dot. The stability boundary is indicated in all three plots using this blue shaded region. So now you can see that for a small delta t, the simulation will be eigenvalue stable. But as I increase delta t, eventually that orange dot crosses over the line and outside of the stability boundary. If you'd like to know what is the maximum time step delta t, for which you still have eigenvalue stability for this problem using forward Euler, you just place the orange dot on the blue line and read off what the delta t is. In this case, delta t equals 0.02 is the maximum time step you can take to maintain eigenvalue stability for the problem with eigenvalue minus 100 using the forward Euler method.